To our kids, they're playthings. To predators, they're a paradise. To big tech, though, they're profit spinners, which is perhaps why policing said predators isn't always a priority.
You have fundamental responsibilities to keep your users safe online. We will be issuing notices to lift the hood to see what you are and are not doing.
In a world first, Aussie authorities have served Apple, Microsoft, Meta, aka Facebook and Instagram, Snap and Omegle with legal orders under the Online Safety Act, compelling the tech giants to explain what they're doing to detect, report and prevent child sex abuse material on their platforms.
Everything from just the proliferation, hosting of child sexual exploitation, abuse and torture of children, whether it's sexual extortion, which we're seeing huge spikes in, or what we call coerced self-produced child sexual exploitation material.
Self-reporting from big tech has been patchy, to say the least. Last year, Facebook reported 22 million instances of suspected child abuse, Instagram 3 million, Snapchat 500,000. But Microsoft, which owns Skype, a favourite with abusers, reported just 78,000. And Apple, with its 1.8 billion devices worldwide, reported just 160 instances of apparent abuse.
It's hard to be an effective regulator with blind spots. We believe that transparency and accountability are just the sunlight that is needed to shine on the dark spaces of the internet.
The companies now have 28 days to comply or face fines of more than $500,000 a day.
Now is the time for action, not just platitudes. I imagine that most Australians will not take too kindly to the fact that these virtual seatbelts and digital guardrails are not being erected by really, really wealthy companies that can and should do more.
AFP Commander Hilda Sirik is head of the Australian Centre to Counter Child Exploitation and she joins us now. Hilda, what are you seeing on platforms like these? How prolific is the predatory behaviour and the spread of child abuse material?
Unfortunately, it's pretty widespread. Here at the AFP-led Australian Centre to Counter Child Exploitation, or the ACE as we like to call it, we got more than 33,600 reports last year, and that's a 60% increase from the year before. And unfortunately, we're seeing everything from the dissemination of child sexual abuse to online grooming, even offenders targeting our children for more graphic content or even money.
Which is, I guess, is what makes some of the reporting rates from these tech giants a bit of a concern. The standout is clearly Apple. 160 reports of suspected abuse from Apple last year. Given all their devices that are out there, is that good enough?
Look, every report is important for us. Of course, do we want all the tech companies to deliver more reports? Absolutely we do. But we just need to work with them to make sure that they've got the right tools and make sure that we can get more reports.
I guess the tech companies are different, aren't they? So Facebook reported a lot more, but then they're also a company that hoovers up all of our data and basically gives us no privacy. Apple, on the other hand, their business model is based around privacy. And I think it was even last year they announced plans to scan child abuse images that were uploaded to the cloud, but there was huge backlash over those privacy concerns. So is there just a trade-off there that we need to acknowledge?
Yeah, look, it's a double-edged sword. Absolutely, these companies, they have to create tools and platforms that are going to keep your information safe, banking details safe. But unfortunately, offenders are also using these tools to commit offences. So we just want these platforms not to be safe havens for our offenders. So anything that the tech companies can put into place to keep our children safe is everything that we're asking them to do.
So, Hilda, for parents who have kids who are using these apps, what can they do, really, if anything, to try and keep the children safe?
Really, there's a few simple tips that you can probably do right now, and just supervision being essential. Know what your kids are doing online. Having really open and approachable conversations. Kids are not going to come to you and report issues if they think their devices are going to be taken off them. Make sure you know your privacy settings. So just make sure friends and family are the only ones that are going to have access to your kids. And then, of course, know where to report. So you can always make a report to the ACCC.gov.au website, or if your kids are in danger now, always call 000.
All right, Hilda, well, long way to go, but thank you so much for chatting with us tonight.
Thanks for having me.